Assalamu alaikum. Sabah al khair, Dalia. Good morning and good morning to all of our listeners.
Wa alaikum assalam. Sabah al noor. Good morning, Yasmeen, and good morning to all of our listeners.
Hello and welcome back. This is the first episode and it will be in Gulf dialect. We are super excited to start this journey with you guys. How excited are you, Dalia?
I'm always super excited. We have been teaching the Gulf dialect for a couple of years now, and I feel sad to tell you that there are only a few books and YouTube channels that teach the Gulf dialect. And in fact, the quality of some of these resources isn't good too. So we are happy to start this. All right, Yasmeen, tell us, what are we going to talk about today?
Since this is the first episode, we are going to introduce ourselves, and you will learn how to introduce yourself in Gulf dialect. Here are the topics that we are going to cover today. The first thing is to listen to me and Dalia introducing ourselves in the conversation. Then, we will talk about the different ways of greeting in Arabic. After that, we will talk about the pronoun I and your. Also, we will discover what are the possessive pronouns like my and your. Then, we will figure out how to say how are you, what's your name, and what else do we have today, Dalia?
Okay, then we will talk about verbs in a present tense, but we will not go into details as this is going to be a whole separated episode. Then we will ask what do you do and where do you live in Arabic? After that, we're going to see how do we say nice to meet you. Finally, we will listen to the conversation again, but this time in a normal speed and without any translation. Alright, so let's start with the conversation, Yasmeen.
Assalamu alaikum, ahlan wa sahlan.
وعليكم السلام أهلين كيف حالك؟
أنا بخير الحمد لله وإنتي إيش أخبارك؟
أنا طيبة الحمد لله
إيش اسمك؟
اسمي داليا وإنتي؟
اسمي ياسمين
كم عمرك ياسمين؟
عمري 25 سنة وإنتي؟
أنا عمري 24 سنة
ما شاء الله من وين إنتي؟
أنا من السعودية من الرياض وإنتي؟ من الرياض صح؟
لا أنا من السعودية من جدة
أها وين تعيشين؟
أعيش في دبي
أوه أنا كمان أعيش في دبي وأشتغل محاسبة في بنك وإنتي إيش تشتغلين؟
أنا أشتغل ممرضة في مستشفى تشرفنا داليا فرصة سعيدة
الشرف لي أنا أسعد
Well, this was a basic introduction in Arabic Now let's explain it in more details يلا
So, in the beginning of the conversation, you said Assalamu alaikum and I replied Wa alaikum assalam, right?
Mm-hmm, right.
This is the basic and the main greeting we use in Arabic. We use it everywhere, in formal or informal situation. So, if someone says Assalamu alaikum, you have to reply by saying Wa alaikum assalam.
And also, Dalia, I would like to mention that many people think it's related to religion.
No, it's not.
Yes, everyone can use this. After saying Assalamu alaikum, you can use different ways of a greeting, like in the conversation I used Ahlan wa sahlan.
And I also replied, I said Ahlan.
Exactly. So, Ahlan wa sahlan, Ahlan, Hala wallah, those are different ways of saying hi and hello in Arabic. Take into consideration that hello Allah is informal. You can use it among your families and friends. But ahlain and ahlan wa sahlan, those we can use them in formal situations.
Okay, now we will talk about pronouns. We are not going to take all the pronouns in Arabic, but today we will take the pronoun I and you. How do we say I in Arabic, Yasmeen?
Ana. Ana.
Okay, and how do we say you?
That would be inta when you are talking to male and inti that is you for female. Inta, inti.
So let me get this right. I is ana, you male is inta, you female is inti.
Exactly. And this explains a lot when we were saying we inta and we inti in the conversation. So basically we it's the way how we say and. So, we inti means and you when you're talking to female or how about you. The same way, if you're talking to male, you would say we inta and you or how about you.
Yes. So, instead of repeating the whole question again, you can just say we inti or if you're talking to male, we inta. Okay, another thing is, how did we say I'm fine in Arabic?
In the conversation, I said أنا بخير, which basically means I'm fine or I'm good.
Yes, and I said أنا طيبة, which also means I'm good, but here I'm said inshallah.
Okay, but Dalia, I said أنا بخير. Should I also say أنا بخيرة?
Oh, no. بخير here is not an adjective, so both male and female would say أنا بخير.
Okay, great. So, as you mentioned before, Dalia, we had the pronouns أنا, أنت, أنتي. But what about the possessive pronouns? How do we say my?
We actually don't have a word for my. Instead, what we do is we add an I or the sound E at the end of the word and it becomes my something.
So, for example, name in Arabic is ism. Should I add that E sound at the end to say my name?
Yes. So, ism with the E at the end, it will be ismi. Ismi. My name.
What about your name?
Similarly to this, we don't have a word. So for your, we add the ak at the end of the word for male and the ik at the end of the word for female. Can you try this with your name?
So your name for male, we will add ak at the end and it will be ismek.
Put that in some countries like Kuwait, Bahrain, Emirat, they use the ch ending for female, so they will say ismich for female. Well, either way, it's not really that big difference as we all understand each other. Okay, another word is my age and your age. So, age is عمر. عمر. How do we say my age, Yasmin?
Then, as we did with ism before, we added the E at the end. We will add the E at the end of the word عمر, so it becomes عمري, and عمري means my age.
And how about your age?
For male, we will add أك, so it becomes عمرك, عمرك. For female, we add إك at the end, so it would become عمرك, عمرك.
We also use these possessive pronouns when we asked about the well-being or the state, like how are you?
Yes, exactly. So for male, when we are saying how are you to male, we say كيف حالك, كيف حالك. And for female, we say كيف حالك, كيف حالك. You need to be careful with the endings that represent my and your. A lot of students confuse them. For example, when I ask Ahmed, what's your name? إيش اسمك? If he replies, اسمك Ahmed, that is wrong. Basically, what he is saying is your name Ahmed, not my name is Ahmed. So we should add E and say اسمي Ahmed. Okay, now let's talk a little bit about verbs. What are the verbs that we used, Dalia?
We use the verb to work and to live. We are going to talk about verbs in details in next episode. Now, let's have a general idea. So, how do we say you work for male?
تشتغل. تشتغل.
And you work for female?
تشتغلين. تشتغلين.
So, when I say I work, should I say أنا تشتغلين?
No, the verb changes with أنا and it becomes أشتغل, أشتغل.
So, أنا أشتغل, أنت تشتغل, أنت تشتغلين. Note that sometimes you can hear different pronunciations, so you might hear people saying تشتغلين instead of لين, and that's also right.
Similarly, the verb to live with أنا, you would say أنا أعيش. أنا أعيش. For female, أنت تعيشين. أنت تعيشين. And for male, أنت تعيش. أنت تعيش. And after that, we said nice to meet you. So I said تشرفنا.
And I replied الشرف لي. الشرف لي.
Also another way to say it's nice to meet you, I said فرصة سعيدة. فرصة سعيدة.
And I replied, أنا أسعد, أنا أسعد.
So this is how we say it's nice to meet you. And we can use them with male, female, singular, plural.
Pretty simple.
Okay. Now let's see the question words we use in the conversation and put everything together.
All right. So the first question is how,
which is كيف, كيف, like we used it to ask the question, how are you? So I said, كيف حالك, كيف حالك, for female, كيف حالك, for male.
And how about if you're talking about numbers, like how much and how many? Would we still use كيف?
In this case, we will use كم. So whenever we're asking about a number and the answer will include a number, we should use this one. As in the question, how old are you? So we are using the word عمر, age, and age is a number, so we should use كم. So it's كم عمرك, male, and كم عمرك for female. كم عمرك, كم عمرك.
Okay, the second question word is what?
We can say ish or wish, and that is in Saudi dialect. But in Emirati, Bahraini, Kuwaiti dialects, they use shu and shino. So it's good to know them all. We used this one to ask what's your name? Ish smek, ish smek. Also we can say wish smek, wish smek. The different varieties of saying what. And also, what's new? إيش الأخبار؟ إيش الأخبار؟
Okay, and the third question is where?
Which is when? When? We use it to ask the question, where do you live? وين تعيش? And وين تعيشين for female. Alright, now that we have explained everything, let's listen to the conversation with translation. السلام عليكم. أهلا وسهلا. Hello and welcome.
وعليكم السلام أهلين كيف حالك؟ Hi or hello, how are you?
أنا بخير الحمد لله. وإنتي؟ إيش أخبارك؟ I'm fine, I'm good, thanks God. And you? What's your news?
أنا طيب الحمد لله. I'm fine, thank God.
إيش اسمك؟ What's your name?
اسمي داليا. وإنتي؟ My name is داليا. And you?
اسمي ياسمين. My name is ياسمين.
كم عمرك ياسمين؟ How old are you, ياسمين؟
عمري 25 سنة. وإنتي؟ My age is 25 years old. And you?
أنا عمري 24 سنة. My age is 24 years old.
ما شاء الله. من وين إنتي؟ ما شاء الله. That's an expression used by Muslim. But you can say this if you like or admire something or when you see something beautiful. And من وين إنتي means where are you from? Note here that we didn't start with the question word when, which is where, but here it's like we are asking from where are you. So we'd start with the preposition من, from, and we say من وين إنتي or من وين إنت.
أنا من السعودية من الرياض وإنتي من الرياض صح؟ I am from Saudi Arabia from Riyadh and you are from Riyadh, right?
لا أنا من السعودية من جدة. No, I'm from Saudi Arabia, from Jeddah.
وين تعيشين? Where do you live?
أعيش في دبي. I live in Dubai.
Oh, أنا كمان أعيش في دبي. أنا أشتغل محاسبة في بنك. وإنتي, إيش تشتغلين? وأنا كمان أعيش في دبي. So, me too, I live in Dubai. أنا أشتغل محاسبة في بنك. I work as an accountant in a bank. وإنتي, إيش تشتغلين? And you, what do you do?
أنا أشتغل ممرضة في مستشفى. I work as a nurse in the hospital. في مستشفى, most of the time the في won't be noticeable. It will be so short and connected to the word. أشتغل ممرضة في مستشفى. في مستشفى. فهي means in. شرفنا داليا. فرصة سعيدة. It's nice to meet you, داليا.
الشرف لي. أنا أسعد. It's nice to meet you too. Now, let's listen to the conversation without translation and with a normal speak.
السلام عليكم. أهلا وسهلا.
وعليكم السلام. أهلين. كيف حالك؟
أنا بخير الحمد لله. وإنتي إيش أخبارك؟
أنا طيبة الحمد لله.
إيش اسمك؟
أنا اسمي داليا. وإنتي؟
اسمي ياسمين.
كم عمرك ياسمين؟
عمري 25 سنة. وإنتي؟
عمري 24 سنة. ما شاء الله، من وين انتي؟
انا من السعوديه من الرياض، وانت من الرياض صح؟
لا انا من السعوديه من جده.
وين تعيشين؟
اعيش في دبي.
اوه انا كمان اعيش في دبي. انا اشتغل محاسبه في بنك، وانتي ايش تشتغلين؟
انا اشتغل ممرضه في مستشفى. تشرفنا داليا، فرصه سعيده.
الشرف لي، انا اسعد.
Well, this is it for today's episode. We hope that you enjoyed it.
Yeah, we have learned many things today. I'm happy that we started the podcast.
Me too. I am super excited for the next episodes as well. Our vision in Alfiya is to make the Arabic language easy and enjoyable to learn. So, to get the most out of what you are learning in this podcast, download the materials, make sure that you've understood the grammar and the conversation all in all.
Yes, the materials are going to be in the description box. We will post in our social media account further exercises and practice of each episode. So follow us, and you can also ask questions about anything.
Also, stay tuned for the video that would help you and provide some guidance on how to study Arabic in general, how to take notes, as well as apps and methods to help you to get the language faster.
Yes, also I would like to mention that I don't know if anyone of you, Yasmin, have heard of it.
What's that?
There is a specific and scientific way of reviewing notes and listens in general, the way we review and the days, so your brain can turn the information from the short-term memory to the long-term memory.
Oh wow, yes, I've heard of something like that.
Yes, it's interesting. We will explain this more in our Instagram, inshallah, so it can help you with memorizing.
Now we've reached to the end of the episode. Thank you for listening and having us part of your journey in learning Arabic.
Thank you so much for you, Yasmin, and for all our listeners. Alfiya Arabic is a broad vision to make learning Arabic easy and enjoyable. For now, I would say, Ma salama.
Ma salama, and see you next time.